Hey there, sheepdoggers! And welcome to the release of Dead State. It's been in early access for a little while. Not that long, but it's been in development for a long time. I found it fairly intriguing and interesting because it's kind of a zombie survival with base building and kind of squad based fighting and that. So it's kind of like XCOM in a little while, except for with like a lot less backing. Financial backing and everything. So we're going to start a new game and see how it's different from the early access that I played quite a long time ago. So we'll see. We'll see. Okay, we have portrait selections. I guess custom is just... This feature is not available in early access. The game's just been released, guys. That's female, however. We will be male for whatever reason. Is there anyone with a beard? Well, there's kind of beards. They're not really... beards like my beards. No. Games really need to cater to the bearded, I feel. But we'll have a little look and see if we can go with a beard, I guess. That will do. That looks like me, kind of, without glasses. So I can choose my portrait as white and then my body as black. Man. And variations and stuff. That looks fine, I guess. That's perfectly. Reginald T. Reginald T. Chinwisk. There we go. So next. Do we want to go preset or custom? Let's try preset and see how it goes. So you could have your own survivalist show. Let's try being a hunter survivalist style fella. So we have keen senses, increases survey on the world map. That's probably useful. Gains additional 5% crit chance with human targets with ranged weapons. So maybe a bow or something would be useful, like a crossbow maybe. Allows for an ally of your choosing to bump up their move order and go next. That's quite cool. So we have survival, ranged, and melee. Survival, how well the character survives in an outdoor environment. And seeing as we're going to be going out all the time, I think that's probably a good one to choose. This will finalize your character. I will accept that. And we'll see how we do. Hopefully we'll do okay. Possibly we will do terribly. Let us beware of saying that death is the opposite of life. The living being is only a species of the dead and a very rare species. Friedrich Nietzsche. I think that's how you say it. Nietzsche? I think. Please correct me if I'm terribly wrong. That's something you don't want to say on the internet. You'd counted yourself lucky to have gotten on the plane. There had been rumors of some kind of pandemic rapidly spreading across the world. And people had started to be getting nervous. I said that completely wrong. Flights were getting overbooked, delayed repeatedly, or outright cancelled. But you in the air, buckled safely in your seat, enduring some light turbulence as you idly watched a newscast on the current world crisis, when you heard a commotion from the front. Someone had staggered on the plane. You heard them struggling with their luggage and all that wet. And that wet. Hacking cough for most of the flight. After the cough stopped, something started to happen up front. You heard a flight attendant scream and utter chaos break out in front. The front. I've been streaming for 5 1/4 hours already, so just bear with me. People jumped out of their seats to try and help, but it only seemed to cause the situation to get worse. There was screaming, yelling for help, and the distant sound of someone banging on the cockpit. Then the horrible feeling of your stomach dropping as the plane tilted downwards, the scattered thoughts that accompany a fear of death. An awful cacophony of metal and earth twisting around each other filled your ears. And then there was only darkness and fire. Well, at least it's not ice and fire, because that would be a whole different story. Game of Thrones reference. Okay. Interesting. This was not where I was expecting to start. Okay, welcome to Dead State. The world here is complex and dangerous. Let's take things simply at first. Please remember that if you ever get lost, simply save and exit the game. Find the game manual in the install directory and look through it. It contains a much more thorough overview of the game's systems and functions. For now, try to focus and get your bearing. Use the middle mouse button to zoom in and out. Got it. Hold it, move, rotate, or tilt the camera. The WSDs move the camera around, as well as the arrow keys. The camera can also be rotated using the Q and E keys. Moving can be done by clicking the left mouse button on the desired location. Do what you can to try and move a little bit further from the crash. Hello, is anyone alive in there? This is Sheriff Reinhardt of Splendid PD. If you can hear me, follow my voice. You think the voice is coming from the near the tail of the wreck. The other passenger, those other passengers, yeah, no, they don't look friendly. Don't look friendly, or like they should be even be alive. Looks like you'll need a weapon. Left click on the suitcase nearby in order to interact with it. By the way, I'm really bad at this game. Like, I always get people killed. I'm just terrible. Yes, I will take. This is the loot screen. The inventory of the character doing the looting is on the left, there. While the object or person being looted is on the right. Left-clicking on an item selects it. The arrows pointing both ways allow for a selected item to be transferred back and forth, while the single arrow pointing to the left moves everything from the loot container to the looting character's inventory. For now, simply select the bat, hit the left-facing arrow to transfer it into your inventory, and then hit X at the top to close the loot screen. Weapons are useless unless you equip them. Hit I, or the backpack icon, and then we put it in there. Thank you. We're trying to put the fire out. Keep following my voice. Look for something to defend yourself with, and whatever you do, stay away from the other passengers. You look away around for a weapon. I've got a weapon. Don't walk into the fire. Walk into the fire. Just okay. There we go. Let's kill him. Can you still hear me? If you have to defend yourself, hit them before they grab you. Whatever you do, don't let them bite you. Looks like you're in trouble. One of those things is blocking the route to you and safety, and you'll need to use forced in order to move around it. Hit the spacebar or click the exclamation button at the bottom, or just wait for it to attack me, apparently. This is combat mode. Combat in Dead State is turn-based, and everything depends on the amount of action points, AP, that you have. Currently tracked in the green field on the bottom center. So, there. This, 9 out of 9. AP are counted both for movement and attack, while moving a single square always costs 1 AP. Different attacks cost different amounts of AP, depending on the weapon, type of attack, and several other factors. For now, things are simple. It's you versus that staggering thing. And the odds for destroying it seem to be in your favour. Move next to it, keeping a close eye on your action points as you do, and simply click on your enemy to attack. He's dead. When targeting an enemy, to hit chance, CS means critical strike. Okay, I should have seen this before I did. Odds of it hitting an enemy increases when you attack from the back or side, so it might be worth it to spend action points better position. If you're out of action points, don't worry, you can enter, exit, and skip turns in combat simply by hitting spacebar or clicking exclamation. Do your best to take out that thing. I did take out that thing. And loot it. There is nothing on it. Never mind. Done. Let's go. We got the fire out down here, but the fire's out of control back there. It's going to explode. Run. You made it! Okay, well, so double left click to run. Okay, and Vic, help me carry and I'll pass out. Hurrah! Yo, insult my O's PC, woo! So yeah, there's not much in the way of sound. I'm not sure if that's me, like, if that's the way I've set it, or what. You wake up to the sound of people arguing, but it's stiff and you can smell the unmistakable scent of rubbing alcohol. You feel like you've been sleeping off a horrible fever. The last thing you remember is the plane going down. Food? Who cares about food? We've got a huge hole in that fence. If we don't fix it, they're going to walk right in here. I know, Mum, but who's going to risk going out there? You? Me? Joel? I suppose I should be the one to go, being the cop and all. Kind of be nice if someone was watching my back. Not my Renee, that's for damn sure. Let's not panic, all right? Speaking of panic, we're starting to get low on medical supplies. Actually, now that I think of it, I should probably change some bandages and... Wait a sec, are you up? He's up! Easy, I realise you have no idea where you are right now, but you're safe. You're in the basement of a school. I don't think anyone has ever been in the basement, safe in the basement of a school before. I'm Davis, this is Anita. You should thank your lucky stars that my daughter was here. Mom, that's Renee, Anita's daughter. Hi, good to see you're finally up. Up, finally. Behind her is Elaine, she's still recovering. That's Elaine there, I think. And that's Joel. That's me, I'm Joel. Officer Joel. I guess technically it'd be Officer Oswald, but you can call me Joel. Heck, any of those will do. Now, can someone tell me what's happening? Do you remember the plane crash? What's the more? Where's my girlfriend? Where's my boyfriend? Not really, I can't remember much of anything. Yeah, wish I'd never gotten that flight. I'm sorry, there were only a few survivors between the wreckage and the, well, it was amazing that we were able to find anyone alive out there. I can still see so many of the... Could someone please tell me what the hell I'm doing here? You're in Texas. Oh my god, that's terrible. Central Texas, a town called Splendid. We're in the basement of the local school. Texas? Aw, oh, shit. I'm sorry to tell you, but you're pretty much stuck here. We all are. But don't worry, we have food, facilities, a generator, and it's secure. Secure? What does that mean? I don't think you understand. Outside, it's not safe anymore. Everything's changed. You were on the last flight before they grounded the planes. They were trying to control the spread of a pandemic. It didn't work. Martial law was declared, shelters were opened, people were evacuated. Those that stayed behind, like me and the whole Splendid Police Department, all three of us, we were just trying to get the last few people out of the area when your plane went down. Most of them were already... You see, the real danger out there right now is there are things out there. Now's not the time. I agree. Look, this is a lot to take in. Why don't you come talk to me when you're ready? Take time. And they go back to talking privately. Seems like you survived after all and you're not alone. Feel free to explore your surroundings. Okay, so let's just grab our stuff from our bag. Boop. So you've got weight here and how much it weighs. I think you have a certain amount you can carry depending on strength and all that kind of thing. And I know all this, to be honest. let's talk to him again. Let's get this over with. Good, I'll get the others. What I'm about to tell you, it's going to be difficult to believe. In fact, it's hard to accept even when you've seen it with your own eyes. I'll say... I'm not an idiot. I read all about the virus going around. It's not just a virus. The illness that was going around, it doesn't just kill or make people lose their mind. It might not even be a virus. It's the end of the world. Mom, we don't know that. Get to the point. The dead are coming back to life. Not all of them, but people that are bit or killed by them. They seek out and attack the living. From what we know, it's not just here, it's everywhere, all over the world. I see. I mean, it's difficult to believe. Okay, what are our options? I'm just going to be like, yep, let's do it. We don't know how long we're going to be here for, and the basement isn't really a long-term solution. We've got enough food to last us another week or so, but we're going to need to secure the entire school. Wait, are there dead people upstairs? Is that what you mean by secure? Not yet. The fence around the school was being refinished when the town was evacuated. There's whole sections missing, which, I've seen what's out there, we're not safe. If those things find out we're inside, if we want to move into the school upstairs, we're going to have to finish that fence. It's not completely down. With the proper supplies, we could fix it in a day. Can't get very far. We drained the fuel in cars to power the generator. There's a hardware store over in Llano. It's a bit of a walk, but it's our best bet. You're going to want to bring back a toolbox and as many spa partitions as you can find. Getting that fence up is our only option. I know there's a lot to ask, especially given all you've been through, but we really don't have a choice. Just the two of us? We're going to need someone to stay here and help me secure the windows and doors upstairs, but I can't volunteer anyone else. Don't even think about taking my Renee. There's no way I'm letting my little girl go out there. Mom, please, I can take care of myself. And what if someone gets hurt? I'm the only one here with any medical training. Take me if you have to. I don't want to have to fight, but you don't drive a big rig for 10 years without learning how to bust some heads. They look about the same age, to be honest. Oh no, you don't, Mom. If anything happened to you, I need someone who can fight. You're coming with me. Don't take my mom. Can't you just sigh? I can just sigh, but I'm not going to. Okay, it's decided. You three go to the hardware store in Llano and get a toolbox and all the parts you can carry. We'll secure the school's first floor while you're gone. You all better not get me killed. There we go. Anyway, so there's some person sitting here. Hello, how you doing? There are set the generator. Oh, we can set the generator now. So that's something new. I've looked in that survivor box. There's nothing else, so let's head on upstairs. Sounds dangerous out there. I should check the bag for a weapon. I've already done that, because I am a genius. Okay, so there we go. Okay, so let's take the. I guess we'll take that with us, and we want that with us as well, along with that, and we'll actually put those in there. Thank you. Dismiss. We'll take the knife with us as well, just purely because it will probably help. Our goals. So you've got Reginald T. Chinwisk. Mood okay, job in party. Elaine Martin is unhappy and uncooperative. Renee is content, no job. Happy in party, content in party, happy, no job. Okay. Recurring goals, I think, are these things here. It's not too bad. These measure the amount of key items you brought back and stocked at the shelter, consistent throughout the game. One-time objective to fix the shelter fence. Build a shelter upgrade, search outside useful locations, find enough food to survive for a week, find 100 pounds of fresh food, find luxury goods, make more and repair the shelter fence, and then you got these things over here. Okay. Each time you complete a goal, you get skill points. You'll get a stat point. Okay. Seems simple enough. Try speaking with people. Okay. So walk around, speak with people is my current goal. Hey, Anita. Let's speak to you. Let's also zoom this out a little bit. Okay. What is it, Reginald T? Ha, sweet. Is there anything you'd like me to look out for? Drinking days, but I still count chocolate as a voice. Alexander spoiled me something's fancy truffles, brought fond memories, deodorant as well. Okay. I'll see what I can find. And then we've got some things we can loot around here. I have played this game before, when it was in early access, so yeah, there's that. Take these, check the soda machines for drinky stuffies, there we go, and we'll just chuck those. I think they're all luxury items. And it's quite funny that she asked for chocolate when there's chocolate in those vending machines. She just didn't think about checking, I guess. So you see chocolate bars, promotes morale. I don't think it's actually food, technically. It's a luxury item, all of these are. So select all, put them over, and take back the freaking thing that I didn't want to take, didn't want to put in there. We've got pillows and stuff like that, that's all fine. Jolly good, jolly good. Let's, okay, let's have a look at this radio over here, shall we? If you're just joining us, you're listening to Lane on Fast Lane here on KHEK. Entering its 8th day of broadcast, bringing you the latest news and freshest sounds of what might be the end of the world. Earlier, we heard squirrel jelly with someone left the light on, and before that, we heard the sounds of me eating a protein bar. Mmm, yum. Yawn. Now on to serious business. I just got a report on the emergency system, and this is very important. Echo effect. Pay very close attention to this. This is a bulletin straight from the Federal Emergency Management Agency, and you know me, I'm not a serious guy, but this might just save your life. According to this, let me just read this part. Antibiotics taken daily will control but not cure the infection. Infected individuals that take daily doses of antibiotics will not show any symptoms nor progression of the disease. So if you're listening to me and you know how to get antibiotics, I highly advise you to keep a stash on hand for emergencies. It just might save your life. I repeat. How can I help? I need to ration the shelter's food for a little while. Anything that would improve your mood. Coffee beans. Okay. And let's talk to Joel. Try not to think about it. No problem. Had a few questions. Specialities. Make place better. Shot your weapon. Willing to part with it. Gotta go. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to be doing the first part, where we actually go out and search the world. We need to bring back things to make this place livable or defendable or, I don't know, something. So, there we go. So we've got foot, horse and car for travel methods over there. And you can see this is where we need to go, Lano Commercial. You've got the time there and the legend here. So, hardware store. JServe, 1991. Thanks for following me on Twitch. I appreciate it, sir or mom. I appreciate it very much. And there's no music or anything. It's very strange. I feel like I should put music on for this, but at the end of the day, I can't really. Because this is, at least part of this is going onto YouTube. It depends how the video does. If you're enjoying this and you want to see like the entire stream of this that I'll do, then, and you know, the subsequent kind of series that will come of this, then give me a like, let me know in the comments, etc, etc. Your party has arrived at a destination in the outside world. Time to get careful control of yourself and your allies in order to be successful at scavenging and survival. Ugh. Okay, so I know all this. So basically, how this works is it's real time up until you find a zombie. There's a hardware store. Can you be more specific about the what? Dead folks, they don't see too well, but if they hear you, creeping right up on you. Okay. So basically, your allies will follow you at a fairly safe distance. It's a little bit annoying. Actually. Hey, Anita. You're much better at fighting. Extra Elise, thanks for following me on Twitch. I appreciate it, sir, or mom. I appreciate it very much. And I can't hit this guy now. Okay, so, and her turn. And then Joel, oh, you kind of need to reload that, mate. So that's that done. And then he can move to here. And he cannot hit him because fuck. Okay, done. So we're going to have to end the turn, and that is going to be able to turn around and hit me. It didn't manage to grab me. You can see here the stats on it. So I took 12 points of damage. It absorbed a bit. That was a bit dumb. She missed. And she killed him. Sweet. Now that you're out of combat, scrounge around, something to fix the fence. Containers with loot. To toggle loot detection on and off, print, simply press Z. That doesn't seem to work for me. Alright. Well, there you go. That is myself. I will take that arrow, thank you very much. Wait, that's Anita. I don't know. Done. Okay, so let's go in here. So we do know that there are zombies in here. Because I've played this before. So there you go. Hey Sausage, how you doing, mate? So we have to be a little bit careful in who we run into. Okay, so we haven't found anyone yet. Still no one. Where are... Ah, there's a zombie. That's really annoying that you can hit them from there, but then I have to frickin' move again. That's maybe a bug. Possibly. I kind of hope. Let's move him to there. He won't be able to hit anyway, but we'll end the turn like that. And let's move him to there. Hopefully he can hit at least once. He can, and he knocked him down. They're not dead. Yeah, they're not dead, but they're down. So they have to spend some action points getting up. Which is good for us. If you take damage, you are not infected. I think it does tell you, however, if you do get infected. Let's search our corpse. She has nothing, so let's carry on. Okay, let's carry on this way for now. Oh, there's one. Okay, so she can move 8, so she'll go to there and smack and miss. That is bad for us. That is actually pretty bloody bad. And hit. And now it's his turn. He is going to move over to here for now. Just purely because he's already been injured and there's a zombie right over there. So, hits Joel. It doesn't mean they're infected if they're hit like that. However, that is hitting pretty fucking hard. Just FYI. Oh, for God's sake, are you kidding me? Oh, please kill it. Oh, holy crap. And I can't hit that one. So, like, I can't get the angle on him. So, missed this time. May hit with the swipe. Missed with the swipe. Okay, good. Oh. Okay. Nothing on her body. And that we do know, however, that there's one around this corner. There we go. Hit her. Oh, God. That I didn't... Okay, that was kind of shitty. So they tend to get a kind of inverted commas bite chance, but bite attempt, I guess you'd say. And okay, we'll have to end that there. I'm going to take this guy over here, over to here, and start. Done. We'll start smacking that door just in case, because you can smack doors open. Oh, actually, we killed her, so never mind. And there is one more Zomblod right there. So let's move her to there. And then to there. Then move him to there. And end. And move him to the shelf. Okay, let's just take stuff from the shelf then. Apparently. And there, and then end. And then he should walk towards us and have enough for maybe a swing. But hopefully not. Yeah, okay, there we go. So now she can move here and just smack him in the head. That's kind of, it's just basically preferable, really, at the end of the day. He has cigarettes that we can take, and now we go to Reginald T, because I prefer looting with him if I can. Let's see what we can find. We've got a crowbar, quite useful. We've got a lot of parts, lovely. We've got some toilet paper, a toolbox, a makeshift pike. Not an ideal implement against multiple foes, or entirely sturdy, but still capable of viciously jabbing enemies or keeping them at a distance. Strength required 2. Interesting. I wonder if we can make that into something even better. So, screwdriver, lantern, luxury item, seed packets as well. Ooh, lovely. You can't carry that much. Well, it's only a matter of time. Okay, so let's use everyone else to carry on carrying stuff. That's everything there. Let's check out the rest of the store. The most important thing really is to just make sure you grab as much as you can, really. Make sure you don't miss any. Ah, there. Okay, so that shows you what's lootable. Lovely. Alright, I see how that works. I can see why they'd need to do that, because it was a little unclear before. Let's bash this open. There we go, and just check. Is there anyone in here? There is not. There is, however, somewhere to loot with a sledgehammer. Lovely. Okay, so is there nothing around here to loot? It doesn't seem like... I'm sure there was something else here to loot, but apparently there is not. Hey, Jack, how you doing? And I think I saw Senvian as well. Senvian, being a couch potato. Nice. This is unenterable. We do, however, have a couple of dead cops. I assume that Joel might know them. Okay, so this could be fairly risky, couldn't it? Joel, careful. Okay, so there. And we'll do this. Okay, so put her there, end the turn. Put him there, end the turn. Put me... Wait, let's just check my inventory, actually, quickly. Is there anything better to use? Clawhammer, to be honest, I think the crowbar's slightly better. 12 to 20 or 18 to 25. Actually, that seems better, doesn't it? So, yeah, I'm going to... Yeah, sure. So what I'm going to do, actually, is I'm going to use this medic bag to heal Joel. You're too far. Yes, I am. So we're going to heal Joel, and, okay, looks like he's seen us. And he managed to get her down. That's not good.